Now, before this, we will learn about entire methods, right? Now, we will learn about equal methods and equal operator, right? So, this is a very important concept in Java, right? So, what is different between equal methods and equal operator, right? So, today we will learn equal methods and equal operator. This is a equal methods. So what is use of equal methods? Equal methods and equal operator both are used to compare between two objects, right? Now compare between two objects, right? So first is a equals methods. This is a very important concept. My question is, what is different between equal methods and equal operator, right? So equal methods. Equal methods basically compare values, right? Now equal methods basically, if I have a two object and if I want to compare two object and both value have same, then return true, right? Both value have same, then return true, otherwise return false, right? Now so we can say that equal methods check only values, not a reference, right? Equal method check only values, not a reference, right? Suppose example here. Class test public static void main string arguments array open. Suppose if I use string s1 equal to Kumar and string s2 equal to new string Kumar also, right? So system dot out dot println s1 dot equals s2, right? So what is output here? So I told you equal method check values only. If both values have same, then return true, otherwise return false, right? So first, before this is a string literal, right? Now then only one object will be created, right? Because I told you if I use string literal, then only one object will be created and that object store string constant pool area, right? This is my string constant pool area s1 Kumar here, right? Now only one object will be created. And another is a string new keyword. So I told you also, if I use new keyword for create object of string class, then two object will be created. First store string constant pool area and second store heap area, right? Now and if this goes inside string constant pool area and there is a same value, then refer that values, right? Now so here is also a Kumar, so refer this value only and another store inside heap area, right? Heap area. So I told you equals methods check only values, right? Now so both values have same, s1 have a Kumar and s2 have a Kumar also, right? Now both value have same and here is a both value have same, so return here true, right? This is output. Write down this. So finally we can say that equal methods check values, right? Now so if I use equal methods for comparing purpose, then equal methods use check value, right? Write down this example. Now next is a equal. So here is some important question. My question is, can I apply equal methods on primitive data type? Understood my question? My question is, can I apply equals methods on primitive data types value? So answer is no, we cannot apply equal methods on primitive data type, right? This is a very important concept, right? Now So we cannot apply equal methods on primitive data type, because equal methods is a methods of object class of string class, right now? Equals methods is a methods of object class or string class, then we cannot apply equals methods on primitive data type, right? Example, suppose this is a int x 10 and also int y equal to 10 also, right now? So if I use here, write this x dot equals y, so what will be output? Here is a compile time error, compile time error, right now? Compile time error, because we cannot apply equal methods on primitive data type, right now? This is a primitive. We know that about primitive and non-primitive, right now? So primitive means what? Int, character, float, right now? Byte, double, log. This is a primitive data types, right? And boolean also, right now? And non-primitive data type, string and array is a non-primitive. So my question is, can I apply equals methods on primitive data types? Answer is no. We cannot apply equal methods on primitive data type, right? Write down this example. Now next is a equal operator. Equal operator. So equal operator basically used to, equal operator check reference or address, not a value, right? So what is different between equal methods and equal operator? Equal methods check values, but equal operator check reference or address, correct? Right now? So equal operator check reference or address, right? So suppose if I use write like this, string s1 equal to Kumar, and another is a string s2 equal to new string Kumar also, right? So what is output? Here is a s1 equal s2, right? So what is output? So before this is a string literal, then one new object will be created, and that object stored inside string constant pool area, right? And this is a new keyword. Two object will be created. First stored inside string constant pool area and second heap area. And if goes inside string constant pool area and same value, then refer that object, right? So S1 is a here, right now? So suppose this object have a 200 address, right now? And this object have a 100 address. Suppose this object have a 100 address and this object have a 200 address, right? So if I use s1 equal to s2, then s1 is here and s2 is here. So here is a not confused, right? Like this, garbage collection not allowed inside string constant pool area, right? Garbage collection not allow string constant pool area. Garbage collection allow only heap area, right now? So I will compare here between string constant and heap, right now here. So if I use equal operator, then S1 have a 200 reference or address, or S2 have a 100 reference or address. So what is output here? Output is a false, right? Because S2 here, S2 stored inside heap area, and S1 stored inside string constant pool area, right now? So both have different reference, right now, or different address, right now? So finally we can say that equal operator check reference, right now? Now write down this example. Now my question is, important question is, can I apply equal operator on primitive values or primitive data type? can apply equal operators on primitive data types? So my answer is yes, we can apply equal operator on primitive data type, right? So suppose if I write here, int x equal to 10, int y equal to also 10. So if I use here x equal to y, then my answer is true or false. True, right now? So finally we can say that we can apply equal operators on primitive data type. Right now? Write down this example.